count on NBC2 to be there.
Place kids love to visit, Toys R Us stores across the country starting liquidation sales today, getting ready to close their doors for good.
Just one of many commercial retailers calling it quits in this area in an age of online shopping. NBC2's Brenna White learns what it means for shoppers.
Well, this map says it all. These are just a few of the big box stores that have closed their doors recently right here in Southwest Florida. Of course, Toys R Us is closing soon. Three Winn-Dixies are set to close this year. Three Kmarts closed last year. And even Saks Fifth Avenue isn't immune. With all of that in mind, commercial retailers say they just need to think outside the big box to keep businesses booming.
In a world of online shopping, brick-and-mortar stores are a dying breed.
I don't think anybody can really keep up with online retail sales.
Shoppers blame the web for places like Toys R Us, Claire's, and Kmart throwing in the towel.
Amazon's getting away with murder. They really are when you think about it, and all these other on site.
Parents flock to the Toys R Us in Fort Myers, hoping to give their kids a taste of the good old days before the store closes forever.
Did you have fun at the toy store?
Yes.
What did you get?
A Mario?
Broker Lisa Sands says commercial realty is all about demographics and hopes what was once a Toys R Us store can eventually turn into another kid-friendly space.
It's a great spot for an entertainment venue, whether it's like a Dave & Buster's, some type of Sky Zone trampoline concept.
Some shoppers worry empty stores will leave the area hurting.
Too many people are out of work, and there's a lot of people that work in these stores.
And Sands says there's no way of knowing the fate of those brick-and-mortar buildings.
Sometimes it takes years to replace these big boxes. Could be years, could go quick, you just never know.
Sands even says some of those big box stores could become fulfillment centers where people can pick up items they've ordered online. Reporting live in the studio, Brenna Weick, NBC2.